It's Finance Friday, and Melissa is holding the phone because the bolt broke on my fancy-dancy two-year-old, light ring thingy. So today, I wanted to briefly mention the things, the basic skills, I have it unposted here, that you need to know to be able to manage and lead your financial statements. And thinking about Finance Simplified is coming up in September. We're going to do another round of it so that you guys have the tools that you need to be successful as leaders, as anybody who's held accountable to financial metrics. So there's four basic skills that you need to have to be able to do this. So if you're a leader that leads people that are being held to come up with financial metrics, they need these skills. If you are the person, you are the leader and you don't have these skills, also you need them. So the language of business and common language is accounting. So making sure that you have the language down. So things like balance sheet, P&L, P&L income statement, the same thing. We make it super confusing, just like the English language, that we try to make it complicated, but we're going to make it simplified. That's why we called it Finance Simplified. So there's also GAAP and IFRS and tax versus GAAP. Those things are different too. Accrual versus cash. All of the things, a liability, an asset, equity. What does all of that stuff mean? COGS, cost of goods sold. Again, a terminology that we can throw around at the dinner table, make it sound like we're super smart, but do you actually know what it is? So you need to know the common language that's used in financial statements so that you can talk the talk. The next thing is knowing the balance sheet and what it really represents. So the balance sheet is a financial picture at a certain point of time. So when you think of this, because everybody's a person, right? So we all have our personal financial situation and our personal balance sheet, which often has the things we own, assets such as your home, your car, money in the bank, your 401k. Those are things that you own. And then there's things that you owe, which are your liabilities. Maybe you have a loan on your house, a mortgage, or a loan on your car, maybe student loans. Those are your liabilities. And the difference between your assets minus your liabilities is your owner's equity in a financial statement, in a balance sheet. And we call it net worth in our personal financial statements. So the balance sheet is super important to the financial health of your organization. So making sure that you understand that, and where things, I like to say in Finance Simplified, things hide in your balance sheet, because we are so, as a capitalistic country, we're so tuned in to the P&L and the income statement, but sometimes we can sneak things into the balance sheet. It's so fun in Finance Simplified to go through some of the fraud cases, because it's always hiding in the balance sheet. So do not skip the balance sheet. Look at it, know what it says. The next thing is the income statement, also known as the P&L if you're in the lingo of what that wants to be called. Your P&L, your balance sheet, or sorry, P&L, your income statement, is basically your income, your cost of goods sold, and then your other expenses, to really understand what your net income is. So that is really the heart of your business, to whether or not you're profitable, knowing that if you're hiding stuff in your balance sheet, then it's probably not accurate. But to get to an accurate P&L and income statement, you need to look at it in various ways. The ways we encourage you to look at it is year to date compared to last year to date, or period over period. So if you're a seasonal business, then knowing, like construction for instance, so Q1 and Q2 usually don't look very good, right? So if I'm looking at Q1 and Q2 of 2021 versus Q3 or Q4 or all of 2020, it's gonna look like we're not doing very well, right? So I need to compare comparable periods to the prior period. So if I was looking at June 30th financials for 2021, I wanna look at where June of 2020 was at as well. That helps you identify, am I doing better? Am I doing worse based on the seasonality of my business? So compare to prior year, compared to budget. Lots of people don't like using budgets, but it's very helpful as a management tool and also to project out. So a lot of our clients, what we do specifically this time of year, where we have June 30th numbers, so we have half the year done, and then we have a budget that we did for the full 12 months, then we can do a projection that blends 6 months of actual, 6 months of budget, and then we can kind of see where we're at. So we can do tax planning, we can do all the things that are necessary to do in the last 6 months of the year to make sure that we're successful and we can make great business decisions. And then the third financial statement on the income statement side that you should be looking at is month over month. And what this helps identify is some trends that are going like this. So if you're not doing accounting correctly, sometimes you're going to go like this. So that happens a lot. We talked about that last week with inventory management. It also happens in different accounting methods. So if you're just recognizing things as they come in or go out, you're probably going to have some of this fluctuation period over period. It really helps on the overhead side to see things month over month, like did I pay two rent payments in 1 month, or did my utilities stack up, or why is my utilities so much higher in the summer than it was in the winter? And it really depends on what you have going on. So we use this in property management, and we were able to identify, because we had comparables, that the utilities were extremely high, and we spent a good amount of time digging into why that was. At the end of the day, we found out that the meter was wired wrong and that we were double paying for utilities so we could fix that problem. But if we weren't looking at that month over month and year over year, we would have never known that. And it was hundreds of thousands of dollars over the course of 2 years. So making sure you're looking at it prior period, comparison to budget, and then month over month. And then the other thing that you need to know as a leader who's held accountable for financial matrix is how to analyze the data. How do I dig into that number that I now have identified that it something looks different than the other, something's not like the other, so I've identified that visually. Now how do I dig into that to either validate it or to understand that that needs to be moved because it should be an accrual, it should be the matching principle says it should be in a different period or something like that. So really being able to dig into that and the profitability. So if you're digging into your cost of goods sold or your gross profit, so that's a percentage of your costs that in comparison to your sales. So it's a percentage of that. If it's going like this, then there's something going on there. How do you look into that so that you can make better business decisions? And that's where all the money lies, is understanding those variances and being able to analyze that. So you have to have accurate data. You have to know the language that's going into it. Know how to read the financial statements. Actually read them like a book, read them. And then understand how to analyze them. And we teach these things in Finance Simplified. We go through some case studies, which is always fun. So love to have you join us in September for that. It's a 6-week program. We meet once a week online. There's videos and stuff that you do in preparation as homework. And then we meet and run through some case studies once a week over your lunch hour. So it's not a huge commitment, but you get the tools you need in your toolbox to be an effective leader when you're held to financial matrix and you can make better business decisions. That's the quick snippet of Finance Friday. I hope you have a great weekend and go out and enjoy life. See ya soon.